Hi everyone, hope you're having a great long weekend. Today I want to talk about a specific aspect that is happening on 12th of June 2019, which is Mars and North Node or Rahu are meeting each other in the sign of Cancer, where we're going to have the eclipse in July. This is a precursor to the eclipse, which is very, very potent and a little bit volatile in nature. This is an explosion of energy that we need to be prepared for and we need to channel it effectively. I'll first talk about the aspect, then we'll go over each of the signs to see where this is going to be increasing the activity, increasing the energy, and how to constructively use that. I will request you to go over the whole video before you skip to your sign. I'll leave the timestamps in the comments for you to go to your sign. So Mars and North Node or Rahu, they come together every 18 months. Whenever Mars and any of the nodes come together, the full potential of Mars is explored. Mars is our courage. Our courage increases. Our ambition increases. Our ability to get what we desire increases. It is a god of war. We get ready to rage a war for our ambition. Our actions are very, very potent and impactful when Mars and nodes come together. We work for our destiny. We work for where we need to go to fulfill our desires and our destiny. But Mars and North Node has its downside. The activation does evoke our destiny, but it also evokes the anger. It also evokes the anxiety. It also evokes the fighting spirit in us. So we need to balance the two out, because this yoga, which is called in Vedic astrology, it's called Angaraka Yoga. Angaraka Yoga makes us go to a stick fight with a gun. It is where we try to fight something which can be negotiated, which can be discussed. It gives us the energy to come out of an oppressed situation. So we can pioneer something, we can get a courage to follow up on a new idea which we were not getting the courage to do earlier, but there is a tendency to take more risk. And why I am doing this video is because this month we have Jupiter and Neptune together. Jupiter and Neptune together are great for creativity, but they're not great for clarity of information. We do not have clarity of information in June. There'll be a lot of misinformation doing rounds in the month of June. So we need to get ahead of this and know who is our right source of information and what we can trust on. When we are getting into this month, at the start of the month, Venus and Pluto and Saturn, they're meeting together in the first 3 or 4 days of the month. That's the best time for us to set our aims for this month. What do we want to get out of this month? Because this is a month of Gemini. Gemini is an excellent, excellent energy. It's a light, flirty, happy energy, uplifting energy. It's an energy where we socialize, we meet people, we communicate, we talk to people, we write. We want to learn new things. We want to add to ourselves. It's a mutable sign. We change our viewpoints. But this month, because of Jupiter and Neptune being together, although the creativity is hyped up, but at the same time, misinformation is hyped up as well. So at the start of the month, you need to set, we all need to set certain amount of goals for this month. Otherwise, we will disperse and waste this energy. In Cancer, Mars and North Node come together very rarely. Last time they came together was in 2000. When they come together, because Cancer is a very potent energy, it affects our psyche, it affects our emotions, it affects water, it affects how we react to people psychologically, how we react to impulse psychologically. And Mars is not at its best in Cancer because we tend to act through our emotions at this point in time. Instead of using our logic, instead of using good considerations, we tend to go with sense of security. We want to do things which are more protectionist in nature. We tend to do things which are more driven by our sense of security and our emotions rather than logic. So emotions and actions take over versus logic when that happens. And at the same time, Mars and North Node or Rahu, they are opposing Saturn and South Node, which is again great. You are revolting against a structure that is not working for you. You are going against a structure, an authority figure, an old rule, a regulation or an abuse that has kept you down. But at the same time, the reaction to that is so explosive in nature that it tends to cause more disappointment than success. There's a tendency to do the things that we sometimes regret later. But at the same time, if we have the awareness of this energy, we can use this in an enterprising way. We can use it to get the boldness and the confidence we need to move out of an old situation and move to the next one, where we have the courage to follow through with a tough idea, where we have the courage to do something against the norm, where we have the courage to strike out on our own, where we have the courage to sort of break the old stereotype or norm or taboo. We get the courage right now to do it, and we'll almost feel compelled to do it. There's a desire and ambition to do things that you have not done before, but there is high amount of deception, high amount of insecurity, which is rife right now, and it will grow as the month of June goes by. I love Gemini season, but this month, Gemini season is a little bit different because it has different energies, different aspects that are forming, which have never formed before. Mars, Rahu coming together, opposing Saturn and South Node, is a warlike energy. I'm sorry to say that, but that's normally how it plays out. It creates a tense situation out of which the only way we find is to fight. And it becomes a very, very volatile energy. But because it's happening in Gemini season, which is a mutable sign, we can change our thought processes. We have that energy available to us as well, which can convert this into a positive action and self-assertion. And we have the ability to discuss things out, especially from 8th to 11th of June. We will have a mutable T-square form. Mutable T-square brings a situation where we cannot brush it under the table anymore. We have to discuss it out. So that can help us modify the situation, look at the situation from both sides, and it can create a solution for a problem if we are facing any. If not, it will just help us enrich our knowledge about how to move forward. And that is the time where mutability comes into play, our flexibility in viewpoint comes to play, where if certain alternative facts are shown to us, being open to analyzing them, not trusting them blindly, but letting that seep in as well, because the ideological extremism will be very high in June. So the mutable aspects that are happening, especially between 8th to 11th of June, they can show us certain alternative facts that we need to be open to, which can help us look at both sides and maybe an alternative approach to move forward on. And that can shift everything. That can be the key to the issue. And that is a precursor to the exact aspect which is forming around 12th to 16th of June between Mars and Mercury meeting Rahu or North Node. But yes, the restlessness will be high, the rebelliousness will be high, we'll be even looking at a very different side of ourselves, a warrior energy will be high, we will see high tempers, and we need to get ahead of it, we need to channel it physically and in an ambitious manner towards our desire, otherwise we'll waste it in conflicts or in restlessness or in just feeling anxious about things. So, and we'll see that play out in politics for sure, because the axis where all of this is being played out, it affects some of the largest of the nations, both in Europe as well as United States. So we'll see some amount of politics be in play with driven by sense of protectionism, driven by sense of sensitivity and ego to some extent. But you think you will be fulfilled by acting in that way, but it normally leads to a disappointment, unfortunately. Last time that these two met in Cancer was in 2000. What was physically experienced and is normally experienced is a solar flare. And we already are seeing it since the Angaraka Yoga started around 14th or 15th of May when Mars entered Cancer. Solar flares is a astronomical or geological phenomena where a plasma cloud is emitted from the sun and it compresses the Earth's magnetic field. So it of course results in weather situations which are extreme in nature. It increases the, it shifts the magnetic polarity of Earth. There is major disturbance to Earth's magnetic sphere, which affects the weather, it affects the telecommunication systems, it affects the satellite system, and it sometimes causes surge of electricity in the power line, leading to blow up in transformers or power stations. So when this aspect is exact around 12th of June, we need to be careful in using the electronic and electrical devices, and there's a possibility of power outage and telephone shutdown at that time. Technical instruments need to be handled with care at this point in time, and safety needs to be administered when it's related to fire hazards at this point in time. There is a psychological effect of solar flare, and solar flare is very much a geologically a physical phenomena. It is a physical phenomena, but it has a psychological impact, and we are already seeing that in action. It stresses the pineal gland. The electromagnetic activity, it stresses the pineal gland. So there is excessive melatonin, which is sort of created. So our body goes a little bit weak at this point in time. We do not feel that physically vital, especially from 8th or 9th of June, when Mars will become invisible and Mars will also be out of bounds. We will see our physical vitality on a low, not the optimal, especially the Mars ruled sign. So Aries, Scorpio, or if you have Mars very significantly placed in your horoscope, in your natal chart, then you need to be aware of that, that there might be a little bit of lack of energy that is felt for a few days around that time, especially around 9th of June. So a couple of days before, starting maybe 6th, 7th or 8th, a few days, 1 or 2 days before and after 9th of June, you might feel that strongly. So being aware of that. Brain usually takes a backseat. We work in a very, very driven way at this time. But this is an aspect which can be used very positively. So we have some of the greatest of the leaders having Angaraka Yoga. We have Albert Einstein, we have Shivaji the Great, we have Abraham Lincoln. People who have broken out of the norms and done things, they have this aspect in their horoscope. But at the same time, there are people who have not used this in the most effective way. Serial killers have this as one of the markers in their chart. I have it in my chart. I have not used it yet for serial killing, but it can be used in a negative fashion. I have it in my natal chart. This is an energy which requires awareness to channel. Otherwise, we can get way too reckless. And the risk-taking capacity can be used in a wrong way. So using the risk in the right situation, not in speeding, not in driving recklessly, not in causing unnecessary confrontation, which can be handled through a discussion. We will see increase in mechanical breakdowns and certain malfunctions related to telecommunication, in cars, the things that get us from point A to point B, so communication devices and instruments, and the satellite systems around that time. So that is what I wanted you to be careful about and aware of. In case of Vedic astrology, this aspect comes into existence right when Mars enters Cancer. So from 15th of June, it is said that you start feeling, 15th of May, sorry, you start feeling this energy all the way till about 1st of July. But in Western astrology, we rely on the exact day of conjunction, and the exact date of conjunction is 12th of June, and then Mercury makes the same aspect on 16th of June. So 12th of June, physically we need to be careful about, 16th of June, verbally we need to be careful about. So these are the dates I wanted to highlight. I've not done these kind of videos before, but I think this was a very, very important aspect to highlight for the month of June, separate from our monthly videos, separate from the new moon video. Now we'll go into each of the signs so we can look at how to constructively use this energy and what we need to be careful about. Gemini, the aspect that is happening on 12th of June with Mars and North Node coming together, they're coming together in your house of material resources. What a beautiful thing to happen in your season. Happy birthday to Gemini Sun, and to all Gemini rising and moon, a very happy start of a new cycle. This is a beautiful time to ask for your right share in terms of your finances. So if there are money resources, if you're not being paid according to your talents, or you feel that there is a property that you're trying to get the ownership of and you have not been able to get that, the issue of ownerships can be resolved right now by you finding the right amount of energy and the assertion to ask for your fair share in terms of your material resources. You'll find at this time that your need for getting your right share will be very high. You'll try to maybe even spend more than what you can. So being a little bit careful on those topics, not being too impulsive when we are spending, or being careful in terms of large expenses at this time, not engaging in getting credit at this point in time would be advised. Not getting into a situation of debt would be highly advised, as well as in terms of our diet, we might consume certain heaty foods. So being careful with your diet is highly recommended at this time. Again, at this point in time, because Mars is here, we might be trying to prove ourselves. It sort of makes us want to assert our ego to some extent at this point in time, which is what I would like you to be a little bit careful about, because we tend to go on a way which is more driven by our need for security, our need for safety, and our need to prove that we are right. So being a little bit careful from ego assertion perspective around 12th of June, but especially around 15th or 16th of June, when your ruler is also making the same aspect. This is especially true if you have planets around 18 degree of Gemini, because this is an energy which does not agree with you. This is an energy, you are a easygoing sign. You're a sign who likes to keep things light. But on this date, around 12th of June, as well as around 15th and 16th of June, things will get a little bit hot and heavy, to put it mildly. So this is not an energy that you feel very comfortable with. This is not an energy that has anything in common with you. So at this point in time, being careful that there might be certain amount of some aspect of you that you have not seen before that might come out and open, and it may not be what you want in terms of your ego, in terms of your self-assertion, in terms of saying things that you don't truly mean. So being careful of that. Especially when we are dealing with anything related to resources, anything related to joint resources, anything related to joint responsibility with people, some of the things related to intimacy, we might be finding a blockage in these areas, and at this point in time we would want to assert, which is required, but we might burn our bridges versus finding a solution at that stage. So be careful, especially when it comes to resources, joint resources, ownership of resources, money matters, or anything where you're asking for your right share when it comes to material resources. This is the time when we need to be careful about our diet and use certain cooling foods at this stage. in terms of our consumption of food. Again, as I said, especially true for 18 degree Gemini, all the way from 15 degree to 20 degree. If you are a Gemini sun, born around 9th of June, a few days before and after, you'll feel this like an in conjunction. So it will feel like an energy where you want to go somewhere, you want to do things that are right for you, you want to assert yourself, you want to get your right share when it comes to material resources, you want to buy something, but you'll also feel a blockage coming from the other side. It could be from a joint partner, it could be from an authority figure who shares responsibility with you. There might be an ego conflict that you might come across at this point in time. And that is what we need to be aware of. You have a very healthy sense of self, and that is what we are creating. With North Node in your house of self-worth and net worth, we are creating a healthy sense of self. We are also creating certain skill set that will serve us well at this point in time. So we can channel this in a healthy sense of self, in a healthy talent set that will bring us value over time. And we can rise above the ego conflict that is coming, because you can easily take the high road over here. The energy is very much in favor of you being able to do that. So I would highly recommend that's the route to take. You also have a very, very potent mutable T-square that is forming from 8th to 11th of June. So you will find yourself at a crossroad of decision making when it comes to your career, just right ahead of that, around 9th to 11th of June. And that is the time when you might be required to take a decision. So this, you asking for the right share comes in conjunction with the decision point in your career, in my viewpoint. And it's your season. It is the time to start new things, and your career would be having a restart right now. You are getting a lot of energy. There's so much positivity thrown your way. The new moon that is happening at the start of the month is very, very positive for you. I'll speak about it in a separate video, but this is something around 12th of June that you need to be careful about and use it effectively. So that's for you, Gemini.